Hello students, welcome to MJC Learning. Today we are going to study chapter number 4 of your subject Bookkeeping and Accountancy, that is Retirement of Partner. So let's begin. Today we are dealing with question number 5, which is on page number 186 of your government textbook. Let's read the question. Shah, Lodha and Dhole were partners sharing profit and losses in the ratio of 4:3:3. Their balance sheet as on 31st March 2019 is given below. On 1st April 2019, Mr. Lodha retired from the firm on the following terms. Goodwill is to be valued at average profit and loss of last 5 years, which are given as under. Computer to be depreciated by 10%, furniture to be revalued at ₹27,500, vehicles appreciated by 20%. So there is adjustment relating to computers, vehicle and furniture. We have made a note of that. RDD was no longer necessary. Shah and Dhule will share the future profit and losses in the ratio of 2:1. It was decided that goodwill should not appear in the books of the new firm and amount payable to Lodha to be transferred to his loan account. And we need to prepare profit and loss adjustment account, partner's capital account and balance sheet of the new firm. So I have prepared a format of profit and loss adjustment account, partner's capital account and balance sheet. Let us start by posting the items given on liability side. First, we have sundry creditors 20,000 directly in outer column as there is no adjustment. Next, bills payable 4,000 again liability side. Next, we have partners capital account. Shah 45,000, Lodha 35,000, Dhole 27,000. Partners capital account by balance brought down. Now we'll move ahead to asset side. First we have cash 9,000. No adjustment, so directly in the outer column. Next, sundry debtors 10,000. Next, furniture, there is adjustment relating, so we'll be writing in the inner column. Amount is 25,000. Next, computers 43,000, again adjustment is there, so in the inner column. Vehicles 45,000, again adjustment is there, so we are writing in the inner column. Now we are done with the posting of balance sheet. Let us come ahead towards the adjustment. Adjustment of goodwill we will be doing later. First let us complete the remaining adjustments. Computer to be depreciated by 10%. Amount of computer is 43,000. And on 43,000, when we calculate 10%, we get 4,300 as amount of depreciation. First effect will show in the asset. Amount we calculated 4,300. On deducting, on outer column we get 38,700. Now second effect, since the value of asset is decreasing, it will go to profit and loss adjustment account debit side. Amount of depreciation is 4,300. Next, vehicles appreciated by 20%. Amount of vehicles is 45,000. And when we calculate 20%, the appreciation amount is 9,000. First effect will show in asset. We'll add the appreciation amount, that is 9,000. On adding outer column, we get 54,000. Now, since the value of asset is increasing, it will come on credit side of profit and loss adjustment account. Amount is 9,000. Next, furniture to be revalued at rupees 27,500. So the new value is 27,500. Already we have the value 25,000. So there is appreciation of furniture. Amount is 2,500. Again, asset is increasing. So profit and loss adjustment account credit side, 2,500. Next, RDD was no longer necessary. So this RDD of 1,000, we are removing it. So liability is decreasing. So profit and loss adjustment account credit side. By RDD, amount is 1,000. Shah and Dole will share future profit and losses in the ratio of 2:1. So this is their new ratio. Now we'll come to the adjustment relating to the goodwill. It was decided that goodwill should not appear in the books of the new firm, and the amount payable to Lodha is transferred to his loan account. So first we need to calculate the amount of goodwill, and instruction is given to us in adjustment number 1. Goodwill we need to calculate by using average profit, and the profit of last 5 years is given. So we'll calculate the amount of goodwill. We know the formula, total profit upon number of years. So we have added the data of all the 5 years, and total years are 5. So on adding, we get 1,30,000 divided by 5, and the amount we get it as 26,000. Now firstly, goodwill is being raised, so the journal entry would be goodwill account debit to all partners capital account, and so we need to divide this goodwill in the old ratio. Old ratio is 4:3:3. Amount of goodwill we calculated just now, 26,000. 4 + 3 = 7, 7 + 3 = 10. So when I divide 26,000 by 10, I get 2,600, which I am dividing as per the share of each partner. I get 10,400, 7,800 and 7,800. So we'll make a note of that in partner's capital account. This goodwill we have distributed in their old ratio among all the partners. Now further, the goodwill is written off. So journal entry would be continuing partners or remaining partner account debit to goodwill account, and that would be in their new ratio. New ratio is 2:1. So 2 + 1 = 3. So when I divide 26,000 by 3, I get 8,667. And when I divide it among each partner's share, I get 17,333 and 8,667. So let us make a note of that. So the remaining partners, that is Shah and Dole, in their new ratio. Now we will be closing profit and loss adjustment account. Credit side is more. So on adding we get 12,500. And from that when we deduct 4,300, we get 8,200 as our profit. Now this profit to be distributed in all partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Let us distribute this 8,200 profit among all the partners in their old ratio. So their old ratio is 4:3:3. Profit we got 8,200. On dividing by 10 we get 820. And when we divide to each partner as per their share, we get 3,280 for Shah, 2,460 of Loda and 2,460 of Dhole. So let us make a note of that. Now this profit we will transfer to partner's capital account. Profit and loss adjustment account. Now we will be closing partner's capital account. For Shah on adding we get 58,680. And on deducting 17,333, balance carried down would be 41,347. Lodha, when we add, we get 45,260. And Lodha is the retiring partner. And information is given to us that amount payable to Lodha is to be transferred to his loan account. So we'll make here. To Lodha's loan account, amount is 45,260. And second effect of this Lodha's loan account will be balance sheet liability side. Amount is 45,260. Lastly, we'll calculate for Dhole. On adding, we get 37,260. From that, when we deduct 8,667, the balance carried down would be 28,593. Now, partner's capital account is closed. Balance we will transfer to balance sheet. of sha we have 41,347 and of dhole we have 28,593. On adding this outer column we get 69,940. On adding the liability side, we get the total as 1,39,200. And on adding the asset side, we get 1,39,200. Your balance sheet is tallied. I hope you all have understood this sum. Thank you. And with this, your chapter number 4, that is retirement of partner, gets over.